What's up? My name is Sarah. I'm 22 years old. I'm from Ohio, but I currently reside in Northwest California. And this is my story of how just this past weekend, I somehow ended up at a swingers party. Yeah. So, like I mentioned, I'm from Ohio. I've been living in California for about 4 weeks, so I don't know too many people. One of my really good friends lives here, however. She lives about an hour from me, so we hang out together on the weekends. This past week, we were desperately looking for somewhere to watch the fight of the century, and one of my friends had this brilliant idea that we should download this meetup app that likes help people within the area with similar interests meet up. So we did that. And of course, when we got an invite to go to a fight party at a mansion in Bel Air, we were ecstatic. As I'm not from California, so I'm thinking mansion in Bel Air, we're about to go like to the Fresh Prince house. Like, we're going to the Fresh Prince house. So of course we were gonna go. The email made it sound really exciting. It said that it was gonna be catered and the guest list was super exclusive. It was like this fancy mansion, so we couldn't wait to go. We got all dressed up. Day of the fight comes. We're so excited. We take an Uber, and it takes us to the middle of nowhere. It's like up in the hills. So we get there, and first off, it's not a mansion. It's a regular house. It's on a bit of a hill, so it's like slightly elevated above the houses on either side of it, but it's definitely not a mansion. We go up, and there's these big, like, menacing doors, and before we even get a chance to knock, the doors open. This really pretty woman comes out, and she apparently already knows who we are, and she's like, hey, let me give you a tour of the house, and then you guys can watch the game wherever you want. Granted, it's a very nice house. She gives us a tour of the house, and one thing I noticed immediately is people are all on beds. Like, the game is on in multiple bedrooms. There's, like, a huge, like, king-size bed in each room, and there's just, like, a dozen people on the bed watching the game. And we're overdressed. Me and my friend both we're dressed like we're going to a party, and all these people are in their pajamas. So that was clue number one. After she gives us a tour of the house, we go into what we consider the least creepiest room, because the people were somewhat younger than 40, and it was mostly girls. We don't sit on the bed, of course. We sit on the floor in the corner, and we watch the game. One of the people on this bed is this, like, Mexican man with these, like, tribal tattoos, and he has on a red Speedo. And as we are trying to watch the game, he continues to, like, stare at us. And then he asks us if we want to sit on the bed with him. He's like, hey, chicas, you guys can come sit on the bed with us. And me and my friend are, like, holding each other in the corner, like, oh, no, we're fine. But he won't stop staring at us. So the game goes off, and things just get more weird. There are more people coming into the house. They're all dressed in, like, underwear. And there's this woman, and she has on, like, a fishnet bodysuit. And then the host, he's like, he looks like Drake. He's like a fat Drake. And he has, like, a tracksuit, like he's in a Missy Elliott video. And he keeps talking to us. We're clearly uncomfortable. He's trying to make us more uncomfortable by telling us we can go anywhere we want. And at some point, I look up, and I kid you not, it's like one of the girls from The Flavor of Love. I would know that, of course, because I still watch that. But that, just to show you how bizarre it is. So at one point, I'm like, I need to use the bathroom. Well, I try to use the bathroom, but it's occupied. So I make the mistake of wandering off by myself down one of these long hallways. And next to the bathroom, there's a bedroom. The lights are on. The door is open. And when I tell you, there was like a full, like, episode of real sex. They were having an orgy in this bedroom that I walked past. And I was mortified. Like, I turned around, and I'm like, I'm like cringing. Like, it's all over my face. And I go to my friend, and my friend is like, what's wrong with you? What are you looking at? And I can't articulate it. I'm like, oh. And she's like, oh, I'm gonna go see what's wrong. And she goes down the hallway, and she looks in the same room as me, and then she comes back, and she's like, we gotta get the hell out of here. So we're looking around, and we're trying to find, like, a safe place, but, like, there's orgies in all the bedrooms, and the Flavor of Love girl is in the kitchen, and the woman in the cat suit is, like, straddling some old man in the dining room, and Fat Drake is badgering us, and we hide in the bathroom. And my friend is, like, yelling at me. She's like, what did you bring me to? What is this? And I don't know. And I'm, like, frantically in my phone looking through the email invitation to see if there's something I missed. And I couldn't find any indication that this was this type of party. And we figured that it was, like, coded language. Like, they were speaking swinger. And that's why we didn't understand. So we're in the bathroom, like, plotting to get out. We don't have a car. We don't know where we are. We call an Uber, but the Uber's, like, 15 minutes away. And we just tell it to take us to Hollywood. And while we're waiting, we're gonna wait outside, but it's freezing cold, and, like, the bouncer guy is like, you guys could just wait inside, and I'll tell you when your Uber gets here. We're waiting inside the door, and this old man. He's like an old pimp. He looks like Pimp the Don Juan. He like walks up to us like eyes us like we're praying. His like stomach is hanging out, and he comes up to us and he's like twiddling with our forearms, and he's like, "You guys can come over here with us." And we are like screaming like we're in a horror movie, and we like make a mad dash for the door, and we're trying to get out and we can't, and it's unlocked, and it's a circus behind us. There's Fat Drake and the Mexican with the tattoos and the Speedo and the orgies and the girl from Flavor of Love and the old pimp, and we're petrified. So finally our Uber comes, we go outside, we run down the hill as if there's a mass like gunman behind us, and we proceed to go to Hollywood where we have even more of a mess of night. Now, I'm from Ohio, and we don't have, like, orgy parties that I know of. So, I guess that's just how it goes down in L.A.